Let me hear you make some Holy Ghost crazy noise right now. Let me hear.
This is a prophetic word. I release your throne. I release your glory. I release your breakthrough. Today, your new glory is coming right now. I see glory leaving the altar, coming into your life. It's coming right now. Shall I receive it?
House of Miracle Ministries presents 2016 edition of December to Remember. Theme, Takeover. Date, Sunday, 27th November to Sunday, 4th December, 6 p.m. each night. Speakers, Senior Bishop James Saw, Action Chapel, Ghana.
You can be here in this visible church and not be in the church of Christ in the spirit if you are not born again.
Prophet Emmanuel Badukobi, Glorious Wave.
There shall be change in everybody's life, everybody. I don't care how long it takes. There shall surely be a financial turnaround, financial improvement, financial upliftment. And from today, may God decide your life for you.
Dr. Markham Watang, USA.
Let me tell you tonight, anyone who appears to you in the night to torment you, he is not meddling with just one person. He is attacking Christ himself.
And I'm still hearing the crown. You know Esther. Who is Esther? You are Esther. Clap for Jesus.
Prophet Daniel Amoateng, LPC UK.
People are calling your name and are saying, Deborah. Deborah. What was your name?
Deborah.
Deborah. Come. They said, Deborah Kayode. Deborah Kayode. What's your name?
That's my maiden name.
That is your maiden name. The Lord said to me that I should pray for you because you too, the same way Pamela of this man's mother was good. There was a woman that was good in your life. That is your mother, but it's like she's passed. Your mother is passed. I hear a name that is called Grace.
Yes, that's my mother's name.
That's your mother's name, Grace.
Yes.
Get ready. Revival has started here.
Yes, Lord.
And it will sweep across the whole nations because of new birth.
Prophet Brian Amoateng, LPC UK.
Do you know anybody by name Esther?
My daughter.
Where is she?
Scotland.
But because of this prophetic direction, the Spirit of God said, I should tell Florence, that your day of deliverance has come tonight. I prophesy over your life. From today's meeting, just look into the mirror. Prophesy something. I am blessed. I am a millionaire. I am favored. I am gracious. I will live to declare. Get up, say yes.
And host Prophet Samson Amoateng, head pastor, House of Miracle Ministries Worldwide.
And the angel spoke to me that I should pray for Belinda. Who is Belinda? My God and my Father, can I prophesy to somebody? I speak as a prophet of God. Whatever that belongs to you, I release in the name of Jesus. Shall I take it?
I take it.
Time 6 p.m. each night. Venue HOM Auditorium, Medina State, Accra, Ghana. Call 0246-813-585. Come experience open heavens. You are too needed to be wasted.
Church, Pastor Brian is not just a pastor, but he's a revelational speaker. That's a revelational speaker. All those who are sitting down, I think now you are coming, you are not coming to church. Stand up on your feet. Because anytime he teaches, it's not just a normal teaching, it's a revelational teaching. And also a revelational preaching. You know, the first day he preached in Kumasi, Esuyeboa, I wept. He preached for only 5 minutes and I wept. When he was in Legon, they came to for service. He preached, and that was the second time, for about 30 minutes with, I think, the group. Listen to me. At times, I don't want to talk about my brothers. I know what God has given them. He's the co-founder of London Prayer Center. He's an international speaker. He has been traveling all over. You see him on social media. Most of the youth call him the fresh papa. Clap your hands and let's welcome the ministry of Pastor Brad. Oh, clap your hands, clap your hands. Everybody, lift your two hands. I want you to close your eyes, open your mouth, and begin to thank God all over this place. Strange, open your mouth, everybody. I want every eye to be closed in the building. Please close your eyes. Close your eyes, everybody. Open your mouth and thank God.
How much in quan? Mahuwa de. Menidado Nemaya Risa Minyame.
Lift your heads up.
Abraham Tiasi Medimeo Sawasa So Mimo.
Father, tonight I receive grace to take over. Shout it in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Tonight,
I receive
grace to take over.
To take over.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
All right, you may be seated. God bless you. You may be seated. All right, are you excited to be in the house of the Lord? I'm very glad to be here tonight. And I've been looking forward to this meeting. And I feel so blessed to be here. I was supposed to fly in yesterday, but something happened. So I wasn't able to. So I just landed some few minutes ago. And I had to go and change and be here. But I know that somebody is going to be blessed tonight. I know that there is a rule in this conference, and if the person sitting next to you, if their shout is louder than yours, they have taken your blessing. So you have to shout and receive every prophetic word. Shout the loudest, amen. I want to thank God for the life of my wonderful brother. The prophet Samson Amuatin. Is that how you celebrate your pastor in house of prayer? Those of you sitting down, why are you sitting down? We are clapping our hands for a great man of God. And I think that I'm very handsome, more than him. And I love you so much. And God bless you for inviting me to come and preach. God bless you.
I want us to clap our hands for Prophet Samson. You may be seated. And to Dr. Mark. Please clap your hands for Dr. Mark. Anytime I call Dr. Mark, it means that I'm in trouble. And he has to come in, save me out of my trouble. I do appreciate you so much. I was in Texas some few weeks ago and he came to support me. I'm very grateful. God bless you. And to my partner, my Prophet Daniel. I do appreciate you so much. We are actually in London and I'm always with him. And now I'm taking him through marriage counseling. So next year, Prophet Daniel is going to have the biggest wedding in London. And we will fly 50 people from House of Miracle to London Prayer Center. Amen. And so I love you so much. And I want us to relax. The truth is, you have nowhere to go. It's Friday. The moment you leave the building, it means you are going to fly. So relax. It's going to be tonight. History is going to be made. Because tonight will be the first night the four of us will minister together. So relax and enjoy yourself. And I want to thank God for the life of our father and our mother, Dr. Gabriel and Mama Agatha. They have done very well. And I want us to clap our hands for them wherever they are. We love you. And to all the pastors, Pastor Abi, the prophet, everyone, God bless you so much. Pastor Uche and the sensational OJ is in the house. Clap your hands for OJ. Amen. Pastor Fire and everyone, God bless you. And clap your hands for yourself tonight and everyone that is watching. And we are brothers and we have one sister. She's our senior sister. She's called Veronica Amwatin. Clap your hands for her. We do appreciate her. Amen. All the leaders of the house, God bless you so much in Jesus' name. Lift up your right hand. Say, Father. Shout it. Say, Father. Tonight, I receive grace to take over.
Take over.
Mark chapter 1, verse 40. Mark chapter 1. Verse 40. I don't want you to miss tonight. You have the NIV there. Mark chapter. All right. A man with leprosy came to him and begged him on his knees, if you are willing, you can make me clean. Next verse. Filled with compassion, Jesus reached out his hand and touched the man. I am willing, he said, be clean. Immediately, the leprosy left him and he was cured. Jesus sent him away at once with a strong warning. See that you don't tell this to anyone, but go show yourself to the priest and offer the sacrifice that Moses commanded for your cleansing as a testimony. Jesus sent him away at once with a strong warning. See that you don't tell this to anyone. Look at somebody and tell the person, don't tell this to anyone. But go show yourself to the priest and offer the sacrifice that Moses commanded for your blessing. Close your eyes. Father, help me tonight in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. When Prophet Samson gave us the theme for this conference, that is a time to take over, the only thing that came to my mind was something called destiny. Somebody said destiny. All right. I want you to understand that each and every one of us, we were created with an assignment. Nobody is a mistake on this earth. The person sitting next to you is not a mistake. The fact that you are still alive is God's way of telling you you can make it in life. And the Bible told Jeremiah, he said that before you were formed in the womb of your mother, I knew you. and I had already ordained you as a prophet to the nation. Somebody shout destiny. Come on, shout it, destiny. What we have to understand is that destinies can never be the same. We can come from the same family, but our destinies are not the same. We can be in the same church, have the same pastor, but our destiny can never be the same. The very day you understand that destinies are not the same, you will never be envious of anybody. The main reason why people are very jealous of people is that they don't realize that destinies are not the same. The fact that you married earlier than me doesn't make you better than me. My wedding might be late, but it will be the latest wedding in town. Make sure that your shout is louder. I'm prophesying. I've started prophesying. Your wedding might be late, but it will be the latest wedding in town. Your car might be late, but it will be the latest car in town. The very day you understand that destinies are not the same, you will never be envious of anybody. We are four brothers from the same womb, but we have different destinies. Different destinies in the sense that I am the last born. So if you are wondering why I came here on Friday, getting to the last part of the program, is because I'm the last born. I'm the last born. I married on 3rd September 2011. But my senior brother, Prophet Daniel, is not married. We are from the same womb, but different destinies. Maybe it was in my destiny for me to marry in September 2011. Maybe in his destiny, it was in his destiny. It is in his destiny to marry in 2017. So you know what? Never ever be envious of somebody. If you understand this principle, when God blesses somebody, you will thank God for the life of that brother. Because the same God that did it for your sister, when it gets to your turn, God will do better, better, greater for you. Come on, shout, I receive it. I'm just going to preach for 20 minutes and let me just go straight. When I get tired, I'm having jet lag. When I get tired, I'll just pass the microphone to any of the prophets. Then we start. A man with leprosy came to Jesus. Ladies and gentlemen, leprosy is one of the most dangerous diseases ever. I was studying about leprosy, Dr. Mark, and what I realized was that leprosy was caused by a bacteria. And the name of the bacteria is Mycobacterium lepromatosis. Listen, when you are being infected by the virus of leprosy, it affects your nerves. It disfigures your face. It attacks your skin. And it affects your respiratory system. You can't even breathe. Guess what? Some of us, we are going through so many things. It's taking our life. You can't even focus at work. You have emotional leprosy. Tonight, I came with one assignment. Any form of leprosy in your life, I command that leprosy to live in the name of Jesus. Oh, come on, shout the loudest, amen. Listen, I realize that when it attacks you, it chops off your fingers. You can't hold anything. Give me that picture and let me show people. You can't hold anything. It chops off your fingers like this. So, you can't hold anything. I wanted to show you a picture of how it is. That is how it is. Have you seen it? So, guess what? You cannot hold anything. Ladies and gentlemen, your problem is not money. You get the money, but you cannot hold the money. The problem is not a man. The man comes, but you cannot contain the man. You are facing some relationship leprosy. Tonight, if I be a man of God, I prophesy over 800 people in the building. May that leprosy live your life. Oh, come on, shout yes. Ladies and gentlemen, when you are faced with the leprosy, it disfigures your whole face. People cannot identify you. This leprosy was so infectious to the extent that, ladies and gentlemen, when you touch a chair, the chair has to go through ceremonial cleansing. In the Levitical cycle, when you have leprosy, you cannot be a priest. You are an outcast. You are living at the outskirts of town. And they have created a place called the Lepers Colony. In the year 1200, there were over 19,000 leper colony in Europe. One writer by the name Josephus made a statement. He said that leprosy, I call the disease the living death. That is how Josephus created it. And he made a statement that it is easier to raise the death than to cure leprosy. I was on the plane and God told me that there are so many people of us. We are going through financial leprosy, spiritual leprosy. But in order for you to take over your possession, that leprosy has to leave. And I speak over everybody in the building.
Jesus.
May that leprosy, may it leave your life now. Listen, I was studying something in Prophet Daniel. When I saw it, I got shocked. Let me show you a picture of a man that had leprosy. And I'll ask you a question. Give me the picture of a man. Some nice man. Have you seen him? Can you see the picture? Come on, talk to me. Can you see the picture?
Yes.
Can you see the picture?
Yes.
I'm going to ask you a question. How old do you think this man is? I want to ask a question. How old? 40. Someone says 55. Can I tell you something? This man is being infected with leprosy. And the age of this man was living in Norway in 1886. He used to play keyboard. This man is 24 years old. Ladies and gentlemen, some of us, you are going through a whole lot. Your face has changed. You are 27 years. Now, because of financial talent, you look like 86 years. Tonight, I prophesy. Am I in the house of miracle at all? I prophesy over your life. Any financial leprosy, emotional leprosy, by the blood of Jesus, I command it to leave your life. Somebody shout out. Come on, shout it out. Shout it out. Sit down. Am I preaching to somebody at all? 24-year-old man. See his face. I say, Obi Nana. Some of you, your whole life have changed. Your face have changed. You can't even go into the midst of people. You are not allowed. You are not allowed to go into the midst of people. But the Bible said, the man who was not allowed to go into the midst of people, the man came to Jesus. Madam, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. When you come to church, can I feel free?
Yes.
Listen, when you come to church, put it at the back of your mind that you are not coming to church because of anybody. Never come to church because of an usher or somebody in the choir. I came to Jesus. I did not come to you. You know what? That is why sometimes when you come to church and you begin to pray, people look at you funny. When you begin to shout and scream, they think you are crazy. But understand them, because they don't know what you are going through. When you begin to shout in church, they think you are too known. And you know what? When you take over, leave that gentility. You are too gentle. If you want to be gentle, go and die. Because in the grave, gentility is allowed. So you know what? Listen. Hold on. When I begin to shout and you look at me funny as if I'm too known, I will just ask you one question. I will ask you one question that if what I'm going through, you can help me, I won't shout. But if you cannot help me, I am going to scream. You know what? Listen. The man with leprosy came to Jesus.
of worship.
I got to push it. Something happened. I was on the plane and I was thinking about worship. I didn't want to come and confuse you with your theology and everything. Because the man that knows the theology, Dr. Mark, is in the house. So I won't come and say, and this and that and that. Can I tell you what worship is about? When you are worshiping God, you are turning God on. You are, you know what? Those of you that are single, you don't understand. But when you want to approach a woman, you start using words. You start touching some sensitive parts. Before you realize, the woman, why you better? When you begin to worship God, can I talk to somebody? When you begin to worship God, you turn God on, and God becomes confused and tells you that I need to do something what nobody has done. Oh, am I in house of miracle? Come on, sir, yes.
Sit down.
I am turning God on. Me that day, me. I am touching the sensitive part. When you give to God, you are turning God on. The man with leprosy, he came to Jesus. He said, I need to turn God on. The man started worshiping God. The only thing God cannot do for himself is to worship himself. So if you can do for him what he cannot do, he will do for you what your father couldn't do, what your mother couldn't do. Am I talking to somebody? Sit down.
Oh, something will happen tonight.
Listen, if the person sitting next to you, if they take their bus and they are going home, tell the person, where are you going? Where are you? Listen to me. Leviticus chapter 13. Verse 44. You know what? When you have leprosy, Dr. Mark, this is so, so dangerous. Chapter 44. No, 1344. And maybe people see them. Oh, come on, come on, come on.
The man is diseased and is unclean. The priest shall proclaim him unclean because of the sore on his head. Next verse.
Hi. The person with such an infectious disease must wear a torn cloth. Give me that cloth. I'm going to show you something tonight. We are my palm. Give me that torn thing. Let me wear it. Bring it. Torn cloth. I brought a tattered cloth from London. And I'm going to wear it.
And the man should have a bushy hair.
You are not allowed to go into the midst of people. Ladies and gentlemen, you are going through a whole lot. You can't even go in the midst of your friends.
Tonight, I came with one assignment. In the form of leprosy. Hey! In the form of leprosy. In your mother's house. In your father's house. I prophesy. Let that leprosy leave now. Somebody said now. Give me that torn cloth
before I get angry tonight. And then me boo full off.
We are ready to take over. Whether the devil likes it or not.
Jesus.
House of miracle. It's our time to take over. There will be grace to take over. There will be grace to take over. Sir, yes.
Is it a cloth? No. I brought a cloth. Where is it? Bafua, where is the cloth? Don't worry. I wanted to explain to you how people with leprosy, they look like. The man started worshiping God. And you know what? I have just 10 minutes. I'm finished preaching. Tonight, we will pray. We will dance. And we will worship God. We will turn God on. We will tell God, listen, when you want something from a man or a woman, you will get to use words. and the woman would do something that is too crazy. Give it to me. This is what is in the Bible. Can you put it on me in a wise way? I said it. In a wise way. Somebody shout, it's over. Oh, come on, shout it, it's over.
It's over.
Can I wait?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
It's not going through. It's okay. Give me the bell. Give me the bell. These people will make me angry tonight, though. I'm telling you. I just want, if you see what I'm doing. Because when you have leprosy, the Bible said in Leviticus, you have to be in torn cloth. And your hair have to be bushy. And you hold a bell. And be clinking. Unclean. Unclean! Unclean! And when people see that you're unclean, they will not come near you. But, Prophet Baffo, something happened in the episode of Matthew chapter 8. The Bible said there were large crowds. Whenever you see large crowds, the minimum crowd you should expect is 57,000. So, pastor, the man wanted to go to Jesus, but he had leprosy. The man started praying. Unclean! My God. Unclean! Someone should come. Let me make you Jesus right now. Come. Come. Pastor, come. Osofo, come. Osofo, come. Osofo, come. You want to be Jesus? So who will sing? Go. I want 10 people to come to me right now. Please, if you understand this, Mapong, I do my preaching with illustrations because some of you, no matter the English we will say, you will forget. You only remember the picture. 10 people. So stand here. Stand here. It's okay. So this is Jesus. I want to go to Jesus. But I am unclean. But how would it be possible? The man told himself, listen, what can come, can come. The Canaanite man, woman, went to Jesus in Matthew chapter 15. The disciple said, send her away. The woman said, Peter, I did not come to you. John said, send her away. I did not come to you. Even Jesus said, send her away. He said, oh boy, ma banana ma ba. I need to take over my miracle. And I need it. My God, my God. So the man will come. Unclean. 57 people. How would this man get to Jesus? Shout it. So when the first person sees him, he will do, he's coming. But they didn't know that whilst they were giving way, they were, come on, come on. They didn't know that whilst they were giving way, they were giving way for him to get to Jesus. Can I talk to somebody? Your friends left you. Your father left you. But they were giving way for you to take over. Thou anointed my head with oil and my cup runneth over. Surely goodness, mercy shall follow me. Oh! I'm done. Put the strings on. 5 minutes. Prophet Daniel, come and take over. Yani Abreu. When he got to Jesus, they have made way already. But they thought they were rejecting the man. And said, your manager thought she was sucking you, but God wanted you to start your own business. The man got to Jesus. Still had a bell. The man knelt down, started worshiping.
Yesu wa ma fein. Na wa sebi bo. Obedi bo. Missi Yesu wa ma fein. Na wa sebi bo. Obedi bo. Missi Oyo di ma fo. No, bet your mommy out. Oh, your time for. Oh, no, Becca. Hallelujah. Now, what's a bee? Yeah.
The first thing. The man said, prophet, if you are willing, make me clean. If it was me, I wouldn't even tell you that Jesus, if I'm willing, I've been facing leprosy for 37 years. You want me to ask if you are willing? I said, God, why did the man say that? Ladies and gentlemen, it's not every miracle that you are supposed to get now. There are some miracles. It's not in the will of God for you to get. If you get it now, it can kill you. You don't understand. In my book, Three Answers God Gives When We Pray, I made a story there in Nigeria. I saw a lady. I said, lady, you are going through a whole lot. The lady started crying, rolling on the floor. It's a man of God. My boyfriend proposed to me. We did the wedding invitation cards. 1 week to the wedding. The boyfriend changed their mind. And the lady was crying. I said, lady, it's in the will of God. He said, prophet, what do you mean? I said, it's in the will of God. The man married someone else. Prophet Bafo. 6 months later, the lady called me. Prophet Brian, I never knew that the will of God is the best place to be. I said, what? He said, not knowing that the man was HIV positive. So God stopped it from coming. If you are willing. You know what? Some of you, if it's not God's will for you to travel, you won't travel. Because I know somewhere in the Bible that says, wherever the source of my fears are dread, whether America, whether Kasua, whether Bekwai, if God decides to bless you, no devil can stop it. No power can stop it. Amen. Let me just... Are you enjoying the service? Kneel down. Now. The first thing Jesus did was he touched the man. Prophet Mark, he touched the man. Why? Because if you have leprosy, nobody touches you. So Jesus said, I am going to do for you what nobody has done in 37 years ago. On the plane, I said, what was the touch about, Minister Oji? I realized that the touch was that the first thing Jesus had to do was to take off the tattered cloth. He touched the man. Tonight, I released the hand of God.
Jesus.
Am I a house of miracle at all?
Yes.
The hand of God to touch you. In the spiritual. I'm closing. That you have been going through. For years. My God. Bring the streets up.
Asochiribom. Tenara. Sehumbi. Otu denara. Abraboy.
Sit down.
Eti. Asapoka. Asapoka.
Na berisi sami na bita.
Miss
si wa se mi bode o ka mi o de ina
bitri wa
bitri wa ka si
to da osa
mi kwane ina mo su me rade mi ma ku wa ku to wa after this conference,
Prophet Samson, I've said in the Bible, God does not need 100 people, only one person.
God picked Adam, he picked Noah, he picked Abraham, he picked Isaac, he picked Jacob.
He jumped. He went to the judges. He picked Othniel, one person.
Samson,
one person. Ehud, one person. Gideon, one person.
Solomon,
one person.
David,
one person. When he wants to change the history, now after the 40 years of silence, he picked one person by the name Jesus. When he wants to do something, he will go into a family and pick some brothers. He wanted to bring aeroplane. He called the right brothers. He wanted to introduce cinematography. He brought some people called Lumiere, August, and Lewis. He wanted to bring tennis ball. He called some sisters called Williams, Venus Williams, and Serena. He wanted to bring takeover. He chose some brothers. Samson, Brian, Daniel, and Mark. You know what? You know what? I went to Dubai with my brother. I'm closing my ball. My brother. Dubai, 21 years ago, was a desert. Give me the picture of the desert quickly. Desert. See? Dubai, 21 years ago, was a desert.
One man
by the name Sheikh Saeed sat down and said, it's time to take over Dubai.
Listen, after 20 years, see what Dubai has been.
Give me the pictures. Now Dubai has the biggest shopping mall.
See, but one man by the name Sheikh Saeed, you know what? God is raising one person. One woman in this building. There is one prophet in the house.
Jesus.
There is one pastor in the house. God is calling you.
Jesus.
I speak in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
What nobody has done in your family.
Jesus.
May you be the first to do it.
Jesus.
Come on, shout yes! Come on, shout yes!
A release of favor, my poor, 3 minutes. A release of favor to take over. When favor drops upon your life, the people that rejected you, I never thought I would be a preacher. I was a very stubborn boy. Dr. Matt gave me my first Bible. I was the minister.
In every family, there was somebody.
But you know what? Whatever thing I went through, it was to the glory of God. Now I can attract over 1,000 young men, not in Ghana, but in the whole world. You know what? When uncommon favor rests upon your life, the people that rejected you. I went to a lady. I proposed to a lady. I said, I love you. The lady said no. I said, yeah. You are saying no to me. Before I was married. Can you imagine? Somebody handsome than Prophet Samson.
Hey.
The lady said no. The lady bounced my proposal. I married someone else. And my wife is so pretty, called Abigail.
I came to Ghana last year.
I was preaching in some ICGC church. The pastor introduced me. Ladies and gentlemen, We have a great man from London. This and this. He has done the master's, PhD, this. I got the microphone. I raised up my eye. Guess who I saw? The lady that bounced me. Immediately, I said, shh. I said, the anointing is in this place. I went to the lady. All says, be careful. I wanted the lady to know that I have seen her. Now I decided to tell stories. I remember I was in Dubai. I was in Australia. I was in America. I wanted the lady to realize that some years ago you bounced my proposal. But there is somewhere in the Bible, the rejected stone shall become the chief cornerstone. Can I prophesy? They bounce you, but tonight is your night to take over. Come on, Holy Ghost. It's your time to take over. The devil is a liar. Go to seven people. Tell them it's my time. It's my time. It's my time. Once in a year. Ezekiel 47 verse 3.
Dr. Mark, thank you for everything you've done for me. You have no idea. If God can use me, God can use you. The man went eastward measuring a line. He measured 1,000 cubits. And that led me through ankle deep. Someone said ankle deep. This is your ankle. My point. This is when fire, your money is able to feed you and your family. Ankle deep. Give me the next verse. But the angel kept measuring. Give me the next verse. He went ahead. He went to the knee deep. Everybody touch your knee. This is when your finances, I'm closing. Your money, your anointing is for only people in Medina. So everybody in Medina knows your name. Prophet Samson. Knee deep is when House of Miracle. Everybody knows House of Miracle. Give me strings. House of Miracle in Medina. Knee deep. So you are doing knee deep ministry and you think you are okay. But the angel kept on measuring. Give me the next verse. Waist deep. Touch your waist. Waist is when you're anointing. Touches the whole of Ghana. Central region, they know you. Ashanti region, they know you. Upper East, they know you. But that is not enough. That is not enough. You know what? I see so many people. So many people. You are comfortable being local. They know you in Ghana and you're happy. But the Bible said the last one. The angel kept measuring. Now it was an overflow. That is when you take over not only Ghana but in America, in Germany. Give me the flag. Jesus. I went to shop to buy this flag. Jesus. In London.
Jesus,
this man of God is a prophetic man. When he told us to bring flags, what flag is this? South Africa. I can't do it. Because I'm the last born. Put this one on me. Then the first. When House of Miracle has taken over South Africa. When we take over Germany. When we take over London. We take over London. Then the first. And put the last one on my leg. And when we take over Nigeria. Now you know what? There is an anointing. America. You know what? I speak as a prophet.
Jesus.
I'm done. Put it here. I speak as a prophet.
Jesus.
I want you to take two steps forward. Now the impartation has begun. Two steps forward. Listen. When I mention the country, you shall take over. Are you ready?
Yes.
Stretch forth your right hand. England.
Take over.
You know what? Is that how you take over something? Anytime you want to take over, the demons are there. So you have to go with the shout. And when they hear the shout, they begin to run away. America!
I take over!
You are getting there. Nigeria!
I take over!
Australia!
I take over!
You know what? I'm not talking about their church branches. You will start a business and you have branches in Dubai,
hey!
In Abu Dhabi,
Michael!
In Germany,
Jesus!
In Spain,
hey!
Wherever the soles,
Michael!
Of my feet,
Jesus!
Will tread,
hey!
I will give you that place,
Jesus!
For the earth is the Lord's,
Michael!
And the fullness thereof,
Jesus!
Weeping,
hey!
May endure,
yeah!
For a night,
hey!
But joy,
Jesus!
Comes in the morning,
hey!
I prophesy,
Jesus,
there is an anointing to take over.
Jesus.
Prophet Daniel,
hey!
I'm getting tired.
Hey!
Can you help me?
Hey!
Prophet Daniel,
Jesus,
please help me.
Michael!
It's takeover time.
Hey!
I feel
said yes.
Somebody, you are taking over. You are taking over. Wherever you go, you are taking over. The Bible says there was a woman with the issue of blood for 12 years. And all the time, people were laughing at her. But the Bible says one day she met Jesus and she took over. I came to declare tonight is your 12 year. The Bible says when she took over, all the people that were laughing at her, they saw her and they were bowing down. I prophesy, you are taking over in the north. You are taking over in the south. You are taking over in the east. You are taking over in the west. You are leaving Ghana, Africa, America, Asia, Europe, Australia, North America, South America. You are taking over. Somebody listen. When I say January, then you shall take over. When I say February, you shall take over. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. Dr. Mark, your time has come. Let the people know they are taking over. Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. The other day, I was talking with God, and the Bible said, I sought for a man. I said, God, how come you are looking for a man? I thought you know everyone. I thought God does not need men. But God said, I am seeking, I am looking for a man. Men are looking for God, but no, God is looking for men. Tonight, God is looking for one woman, one man. If you are the one, shout, I am the one, I am the one, I am the one. Listen, listen, God is not happy. Why? Because what he's looking for, he has not found. But right now, I saw the face of God and he's laughing. Why? Because tonight he has found just you. He has found you. You are the one to take over. You are the one to take over. Prophet Samson, take over. Shout yeah! Shout yeah! Shout yeah! God is looking for a man. One day David was in the bush, and one day they heard a noise. They heard what, a knock at the door. They were looking for somebody. They were looking for a David. Tonight there is a David here. I said tonight there is a David. You might be in the forest, but today God is interested in your case. You might be at the backside of life, but God is interested in your case. I prophesy, you are moving from the bush to the palace, from the backside of life to the front side of life, from poverty to prosperity. Shall I receive it? Shall I receive it? One day Jesus said, I'm going to die, and on the third day I will resurrect. When men heard that Jesus said, on the third day I will resurrect, they went to carry a stone
to block the mouth of the tomb so that Jesus cannot come back to life. Some of you, they are blocking you. They are blocking your business. They are blocking your ministry. But when God wanted to resurrect Christ, he sent angels to come and roll the stone. Any stone on your marriage, any stone on your business. Do you understand a stone? A stone is a representation of an altar. A stone is a representation of a shrine in your father's house, in your mother's house. Tonight, any shrine on your marriage, any shrine on your business, I want a stone. I want a stone. Shut yes!
Now listen. The Bible says when David met Goliath, he went to pick stones, and the stones were five. Do you know the reason why the stones were five? Because we have J, E, S, U, S. So the five stones represented the name of Jesus. Somebody physically, you don't have any stone, but there is something you have. It's the name of Jesus. At the mention of the name, every knee will bow, sickness will bow, torment will bow, frustration will bow. In the next 1 minute, we are about to shout Jesus, and any Goliath in your life is bowing down now. 1, 2, 3, let's go.
Man, don't tell this to anyone. Ladies and gentlemen, I had a problem with Jesus because he said, don't tell this to anyone, but tell the priest. Don't tell this to anyone, because, ladies and gentlemen, it's not every testimony you have to share. Wait for it to mature. I said, God, if you said you didn't tell it to anyone, what about the priest? He said, Brian, because it was the priest that declared them unclean. So go back and tell the same people that told you that you are unclean. But tonight, that tonight, the tables have turned. You know what? When you are in the leper's colony, you are done. There are over 1,000. You know what? I want the audience to be very sensitive, because over 70 people in the building, an anointing has fallen on you. Some people begin to shake. Some people be crying. In the lepers colony, you know what? Also, for there were over 1,002 people. So they had a porter that every day the porter will come and mark a register to see if everybody is there. But on that fateful day, December, to remember, it was December, the porter came, took the register, started mentioning him. The name of the leper was Gregory. So they started mentioning the name. A child, there was a leper there, present. Started mentioning the name, Badu, present. But it got to the leper, Gregory. They say absent.
Jesus.
Can I say something? When poverty is looking for your door, it's absent. Now I declare poverty absent from your life. Au ewuradi yeswe omona mi dimiremase ajinkwa jimio. Hey.
ewurade yesu kumuna me di mi remase aji kwaji mi o
free a prego si atoye
enti fi ko si anafo
mi obiara ka o mete me ho sa wo sa sa wo na mi ba mo mi ho ba every a time for this is at your
home
what to me so sa mo pa ma sa si
mo sa bi sa ti
ya ro a time to e wu ra te sa wo mi a na wo sa go
fingernails, and they have gathered in Adzim. Adzim, ask her. Adzim, do you know anybody from Adzim?
Yes.
Three women have gathered, and they are about to mix that ingredient, and they are about to throw on this lady tonight. You know what? But as we are singing, the Spirit of God said, "Brian, wherever they have gathered right now,
Jesus,
we send fire into their cups."
Amen.
Somebody say fire!
Fire!
Minya miya ya wie.
Aka se be pre. Oni ben so. Ya ya ya. Aka se be pre. Oni ben so. So minya miya ya wie.
Peja onsa.
Aka se be pre.
Bring it to me, bring
it. Ya ya ya. Aka se be pre.
Stretch forth your hands. Prophet. Prophet Daniel has finished all the prophecy. May the minimum number call. Then we will impart. One of the women does not come from Adzim. One of them comes from Seshi. Ask her. That's where your father comes from.
My mother.
Your mother. Listen. They have taken this lady's womb and they are pounding the womb. Anytime this lady is in the menstrual cycle, they come and lick the blood. But tonight,
Jesus.
You know what? God is raising some prophets in the building. Say, come to me. What's your name? Francis what? Come to me. You say you're called Francis. I see a woman standing behind you, and the woman is praying for you. Yes. The name of the woman is Asidina.
Wow. Yes, my
mother. That's your. Listen to me. I don't know what you do, but I see this man. I'm going to put two flags on you. As I put these two flags, the Spirit of God is telling me that they are the corporate anointing of all the brothers. God is pouring it on this boy. There has been an altar that has been raised in your father's family, and they have said nobody will make it. You know what? In your day, whatever thing you do, I see you pastoring over 2,000 member church. Lift up your right hand. Lift up your. Play something on the keyboard for me. Play something. Play something. What are you playing? What are you playing? Listen to me. Listen to me. I want an usher to stand behind him. Some people have shot an arrow from Koforidia. Koforidia. Sir?
Yes, please. That's where.
That's where your camera is. Yes. Come to me. Come to me. They want you to be paralyzed. Pastor Samson, where is Pastor Samson? This boy is going to travel to over 16 countries. Mission, come on. We have a lot of things to do, so I need to speed up. Come to me. Come to me. Open your pass. Receive the anointing to prosper. Receive the anointing to prosper. Receive that anointing to prosper.
Jesus.
You are to swim in money, but something is limiting you. Come to the altar. You know what? Lift up your two hands. I need to control the time. Kneel down. I've not met you before. I've not spoken to you before. Whatever altar they have raised from Koforidia, I cancel it. I cancel it. I send it back to the sender. I use this man as a point of contact. Any plans of the enemy, I cancel it right now.
Jesus.
I hear a name. Esther. Esther. Anybody by the name Esther, come. Esther. Look at me. Look at me. Look at me. Lot of you. Stretch forth your hands on the altar. What's your full name? Listen to me. Never ever in your life try abortion, or that will take your life away. There are three people standing right now. You are feeling a sensation on your feet, like fire is on your feet. Lift up your two hands right now. And now I want to call the brothers. In the spirit coming from Volta region against your life, lose your home.
Jesus.
You are covered in the attack from Petoy.
Jesus.
I cancel it.
Jesus.
Now.
Jesus.
Now. Lift up your two hands. It's an impartation night. Dr. Mark, come. Yes. Lift up your two hands.
Midi was a dear.
You know what? Come to the altar. Push, come to the altar. It's a Friday in Patensi
night.
Lift up your two hands. It's very real for you to see brothers like this. And we love each other. That produced the anointing. Maybe you are standing there. You are saying that I need an unusual grace to take over my family. Some of you, there are curses in your family. I'm going to pass it to Prophet Daniel to release. It's impartation night. You have to receive it. Lift your two hands up. I want the ushers to be very sensitive, because some people are definitely going to be hurt. Lift up your two hands.
Lift up your two hands. Can I get a bottle of water? In the next 2 minutes, wherever you are supposed to be in life, Jesus, by now, that you've not been able to get there, God is going to push you there.
Amen.
Hold the hand of your neighbor. Join it together and lift up your two hands. There's going to be a heavy move of God. Heavy move. Can somebody hold the microphone for me? Just hold the hand of your neighbor. Yeah, let them hear. Just lift up, join your hands. In the next 2 minutes, great people that will be recognized in the whole world.
Jesus.
I see them here.
Jesus!
Listen, I'm about to count three. When I shout number one, you shout Jesus. Two, Jesus. On the third one, you shout Jesus continuously. There's going to be a heavy wind, because the angel is blowing right now.
Jesus!
When I shout number one, you shout Jesus. Number one,
Jesus!
Number two,
Jesus!
Number three, that's a ten.
Jesus!
Yes, 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 yes!
Jesus!
Jesus! Yes, 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 yes!
Jesus!
I see it, I see it!
Jesus!
I see it! I see it!
Jesus!
I see it!
Jesus!
I see it! I see it!
Jesus!
I see it!
Jesus!
For the last time, join the hand of your neighbor. Now join the hand. Now don't close your eyes. Open your eyes. Somebody hold it for me. Open your eyes. Now open your eyes. Don't close your eyes. Now hold the hand of your neighbor. Now just look into my eyes. People, God is going to place them in strategic positions, who are going to take over continents and nations. I see them here in every sphere of life. From business, entertainment, ministry, education, you are getting there. Just hold the hand of your neighbor. Now look at me. I see one angel that is standing here. And the angel is blowing the wind. And the angel is blowing it on this side. Now look into my eyes. The angel is moving from here to here. Now.
Jesus. Jesus.
Receive that grace.
Jesus.
May the fire.
Yes, Lord.
Move now.
Yes, Lord.
Now it is moving.
Right now.
Now it's moving.
Right now.
Yes, it's moving.
Yes, Lord.
It's moving.
Yes, Lord.
Receive it.
Now.
Kabalaba, lift up your two hands. Baba, we are in your presence. Lift it up for me. Let it rain. There is a spiritual rain which is falling right now. There's glory right there. Close your eyes. Lift up your two hands. Let it fall.
Open the front.
I see.
Fire!
There's fire! to me. One day God wanted to change the life of a man called Joshua. Come, sir. God uses men. The Bible says, he called Moses and said, Moses, I want to change somebody's life in HOM. But I am God, I cannot do it. I have a spirit called wisdom. I want to give to a man called Joshua. But I cannot give to Joshua. Moses, go and lay your hand upon Joshua. And the Bible said, when Moses laid a hand on Joshua, the spirit of wisdom came upon Joshua. In this atmosphere, I don't know what you need. Whether a spirit of prosperity,
Jesus,
or a healing
Jesus,
spirit, a prophetic spirit. In this atmosphere,
yes, Lord,
as we blow in the air,
yes, Lord,
there's a release. We might not touch everyone, but as you breathe in the air,
Jesus,
something of heaven is entering your life.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
Lift up your hands. This guy will take the gospel to the ends of the world. For I see him fly planes. Men will serve this man. Men will serve him. Prophet Samson.
Now everybody just raise your hands. Let's raise your hands. It's not only about you falling down, but something must enter you. After falling down, your life must change. Enough of coming to church without results.
Jesus.
Are you ready for a change?
Yes.
The gospel is about prosperity. That when God, you meet God, your level, everything must change.
Yes.
And you are living here not just falling down, but the spirit of Elohim that has changed all the four brothers. That spirit is coming into your life.
Amen.
He said, it is I give thee power to get wealth. What I'm doing right now is for the spirit of prosperity to hit your life, to hit your ministry. Are you ready for that? Raise your two hands up. I want you to desire it. Just be ready. Something is happening right now. I see a wind blowing. Now, in the name of Jesus, whatever that belongs to you in life,
Jesus,
whatever that belongs to you,
my
as
God,
a Christian,
Jesus,
tonight I release it in the name of Jesus.
My God,
may you prosper
now.
And may you prosper.
Amen.
May you be complete in life.
Jesus.
May you be complete in life.
Jesus.
May you be complete in life.
Jesus.
Shall I receive it?
I receive it.
What did you know? That certain people after church, you go home, and normally you go and you are crying. After coming to church and fasting as a pastor, still you cannot pay your bills. It's an error. So it's an error.
It's an error.
I stand here as your Moses. To Joshua, he needs Moses. To Elijah, he needs Elisha. When Elisha locates Moses, it's an error. Jesus just needed one person to introduce him. John the Baptist. My duty is to introduce a Jesus.
Yes.
To introduce the next billionaire.
My God.
To introduce the next minister of God.
My God.
Receive the power.
Receive it.
Receive the power.
Receive
that power.
Receive,
receive that power.
Receive.
Shall I receive it three times?
I receive.
Two.
I receive.
Three.
I receive.
Shall.
Yeah.
Receive it now. Receive it now. Receive it now. Receive it now. It's coming right now. Take it. Take it. Take. In Jesus.
Lift up your right hand. Lift it up. We are closing very soon tonight. We want to appreciate the presence of Honorable Desmond Elliott and Honorable His Excellency Emeka Ike.
Please, and our dear, please, I want you to clap your hands for they are in the house, Desmond Elliot. And tomorrow is going to be a wonderful time. If you don't know, Desmond is one of the top politicians in Nigeria. Listen to me. Listen. Listen. Just going to pray for some two people. Then, God bless you. God bless you. Come on, just appreciate them. Tomorrow is going to be something else. Just let them say something because they want to go to the hotel and rest. So just say something.
Praise the Lord, God's people. Baba o That's our strength. That's our God. That's the solution. That's why you're here today. Somebody say babao. Hallelujah. We'll see you tomorrow. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I bless God. I thank God for this time. I thank God for this invite. I just want to say I can't wait to have fellowship with you in God's presence. It's an honor to be here. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Where you are not free or warm, where my enquan aye, in tea dawasia. Let me see your hands up. Missy, where you are not free or warm. What my inquan hey, and tea at the wassia. See, Missy, where you are not free or warm. What my inquan hey, and tea at the wassia. Na untia sie oti na hinkwa o koneso sing unto him ina mune Jehova se sora mofutu make my money from God. Thank you Jesus, we bless you. We are happy to be here and we'll be here every day. Tomorrow we'll see you all. God bless you.
Lift up your right hand. We are still, you know what? I'm happy because nobody's leaving. Bring the strings up. You know what? That guy standing there, the one in white. Please, who is Emmanuel? You are Emmanuel. Come to me. Oh, no, 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 no. You know what? The Amwati brothers, we are not excited about the mentioning of names. Now, in Ghana, everybody mentions names. Everybody. So, if somebody can mention your name, that does not make the person a prophet. A true prophet is somebody that says, thou sayeth the Lord tomorrow about this time. Prophet Daniel went to Sierra Leone, stood on a pulpit and said, if I be a man of God, I stop Ebola. And after 2 months, Ebola stopped. That is prophecy. Man of God, I saw in the realm of the spirit that this man was walking through a narrow road. And I saw 7 demons that was chasing this man. They have cut short the destiny of this man. You know something? Also, whatever this man would do in life, his original destiny, he has to open 7 electrical shops. Do you know electricals? Yes. Listen, I saw this man would get a call from somebody. Mark 6 months from today, the call will come from a man by the name Charles. The man will call you to come and do something in the house. The demons have plotted that if we don't pray and cancel it, this man will be electrocuted and this man will die. Because I saw a crown, 7 crowns over this man, and the demons were taken. Emmanuel Asa, A-S-A-H. What's your name?
Emmanuel Asa.
Yesu Udoiya Otoye
Amawato Otoye Muyetu Otoye Siasi.
Where is it?
Yesu Udoiya.
You have a circle. Prophet Samson, come and sit down. Come and sit down. You have a circle. Go and sit down.
Yesu Mishata Etitomi Otoye Amawato Otoye Muyetu Ota mensasi, Yesu misha ota etitamia. Ota iya wawato, ota emu yetu. Ota mensasi, ucha wahini ro. Be vyasimu, ube uji minko. Depe pa meboni nina. Wansha meboni yo, wansha memumu ye. Yes, Yesu Udoiti Ube Uche Mekwa. Oh, Yesu we Mitumi Nchi Awaka Eti Midi Mihunina Mawe Urade. Oh, Yesu we Mitumi Nchi Awaka Eti Midi Mihunina Mawe Urade. Yesu Udoiya Ode. Made me hope and my Jesus. I'm crying in a moment. Yarimo, Yamo, Mimi Tamada. Made me hope and my Jesus. I'm crying in a moment. Yarimo, Yamo, Mimi Tamada. And if Tika, we and Tampa, Raya Sucha, Asuke Beya Woody.
Sit down. Nobody dare to live under this presence. Friday night, where are you going? This man in his destiny. You're supposed to be great, but something has pushed you 7 times back. Where is the England flag? Give me the London flag. Give it to me right now. London flag. You know what? Prophet, this man, in the next 2 years, this man will get 7 houses in London. Because those same demons, they were the same demons that killed this man's father. They killed Mr. Raymond. Just like that.
Yes. That's my father.
That's your father. Give me the London flag. Put it. Sir, I want to ask you a question. Do you know London?
Yes. I've been there before.
You've been there before? I'm taking you back to London. Oh. All those that are clapping. I prophesy,
Jesus.
Receive that international door. Shout yes.
enye obi na ne chewa de suwa na ni mu aye o come on adisu aye o obi aye o obi ika kwa sema na ya yo fi papa muka wa kana so wa ba ye hude ya mi ya wa mo wa mo esu ye ye come on ni pana ni mezi come on we ya mi de ni mu mezi si mo na mi si be mo the sia di kurubi na ye ye ma fo na ye ye ko so na su ni ni na ra ye mi wo fo mo na lo cha de ma so e ni ya di wa mo na mo esu ye ye come on ni pana ni mezi come on
you are sitting down
Come on now,
Marty.
You go to my table,
so ma,
so ma,
Somebody shout, yeah!
Get up. Insurance. Have you done it before? Yes, sir. You've done insurance before?
Yes.
Let me tell you something. Me bra, then I pass the baton. Are you enjoying the service at all? The things you do for me,
nobody can do.
Wait. Bako Ashiasi. Bako Ashiasi. Lift your two hands, all those. Receive them. Two people standing. The hand of God is touching two people right now. Receive it now. Take it now. Two people, take it. Bring them to me. My God. The things you do for me, nobody can do. The joy you do bring my way. In the blood of my mind. Bring them to me now. Bring them to me.
We have never seen this kind of God before.
Three snakes have married this lady, and they are saying that this lady can never ever marry. But you know what? I speak in the name of Jesus.
Jesus!
I receive marital grace,
my God,
for this lady.
Amen.
There are four people here.
Jesus!
Get four people. Jesus. An anointing is falling upon
my God.
Four people. Jesus. Give me those four people right now. Holy Spirit. One, two. Jesus. International door.
Yes, Lord.
Says, bring
yes.
that lady.
Yes, Lord.
Says, bring that
yes,
man.
Lord.
Oh, my God,
Jesus.
My God. Bring them to me now.
Jesus.
Bring them to the front. Oh, glory to Jesus.
My God.
Sir, look at me. Anybody you know by the name Lydia, pray for the person. What did I make? Me tell Lydia.
That's my fiancé.
Your fiancé? Oh, bruh.
The things you can do for me, nobody can do. The girl you can bring my way. You need to blow my mind. Hello to my way. As it goes to see you.
We have never seen this can't got me. When do you want to marry Lydia?
January.
My team so is done.
Amen.
Hey, come to me. On their way on him, where they are in the third week of January. And then I'm planning somewhere third week. On their wedding day, about 4-7 Ebeba. Omu free wo bushiemu neba. But you know what? Immediately they try to enter. May tender strike them.
Amen.
Come. May come abum. Spiritually,
Jesus.
Now, physically, January.
Jesus.
Abba Mary.
Abba Mary. Abba Mary.
Abba
Mary. Abba Mary. Abba Mary. Abba Mary.
son is a what in another? What in another? Hey, you small, eh? You chop kiss. Oh, boy, Lydia.
I didn't know you would favor me this way. I didn't know you would favor me this way. I didn't know you would favor me this way.
Thank you, Jesus. Mahu umma, umma. Mahu se uyame bie, uyame bie. Our problem be niyem. The stomach hurts all the time. So now she's afraid that there will be a surgery.
Yes.
An old woman comes to sit on her every night. And the old woman is saying that, Lydia, you can never, but tonight, we are sending fire to that old woman.
Fire, fire, fire. Fire fall on me. Fire, fire, fire. Fire, fire, fire. Fire, fire fall on me.
Sir, I see you standing here, but I see your footsteps in Obuasi.
Yes, please. I'm from Obuasi.
Hey! You have to leave Obuasi.
I'm now in Accra now.
Huh? You are in Accra now? Because you have to leave. There is a demon in Obuasi. The demon has 26 eyes. And wherever you go, the demon is after you. As you have come to Accra, you are going to meet a man. The name of the man is Philip Ampong. Philip Ampong is going to meet you. You will give a prophecy to Philip. Philip will get a contract over $2 million. And I see Philip writing a check of $200,000 for you. Can I prophesy at all? Me wasembi sabi kaka ya no me pente mobe
ha me puwa mi ho oda me na sembi so osi mi muntino sabi kaya na me na.
I command it to lift loose now.
Yes.
The woman has fallen down. The woman has fallen down. Fine, bro. Ushers, something is going to happen right now. The woman was holding two scissors, wanted to cut off the intestines. And what would have happened was that this lady will get into labor, go into the hospital, and they will employ a nurse. The name of the nurse is Joyce, Joyce Asante. And the nurse will come and inject Lydia. So by the time the fiancé, the husband comes back, they will say that Lydia is gone. But tonight... Oh, am I in Prophet Samson's church? Yes. I said tonight.
Yes, Jesus.
Several days I was so open some new bed. Yes,
Auntie Rose, Rose Tete, Rose Tete, Rose Tete, Rose Tete, Rose Tete. Listen, Rose Tete. Osses. I see three dwarfs following this woman. And by the 19th of December, they will push this woman into an operation. And the operation, they will cut off the breast of this woman. Pick this woman up. Pick this woman up. Cut off the breast. Be their chair. I want you to ask her that our heart didn't feel. How does she feel? Oh my God.
No, no, no.
Huh?
Menofo.
Wait.
Menofo.
Your breast. Which one?
This one.
The woman is touching the two breasts. He said, this one. This one. I'm confused. Madam, which one? Which one?
It started from this one.
Uh-huh. And it has come. Do you want us to cancel breast cancer from this woman?
Yes.
Oh, listen. Why are you very gentle? Yes. You know what? The last thing we are going to do, prophet, is to impart money, money, money. Why are you gentle like that? Why? Why? You are gentle. Dr. Mark, I was going to Dubai. Going to Dubai, oh. Dubai. Do you know Dubai?
Thank you.
I was going to Dubai. I was sitting on my seat. There was an Asian man sitting by me. A great man of God, Apostle Danjuma, all the way from Nigeria. Clap your hands for this man of God. Oh, come on. Make that church in Nigeria. I preach for your friend, Apostle Esther, in Texas. Mega church. I was sitting on the flight. I was talking to an Asian man. The Asian man asked me a question. He asked me, where are you going? I said, this plane is going to Dubai. Are you mad? So I said, I'm going to Dubai. So I asked him, where are you going? He said, I'm going to Joycelyn. Joycelyn. So I was confused, but me, when I'm confused, I pretend as if I know. I said, oh, okay. Okay. Charlie, I don't know what Joycelyn is. So I took up my phone, and I wanted to. Some people asked the woman that who is Isaac Teke?
My first son.
Your first son. I'm going to say it, the woman. Stop it, wait. Let me finish my Joycelyn thing. Pastor Oje, so I took my phone and I typed list of countries in the world. Joycelyn. I didn't see Joycelyn. So the plane took off 4 hours. I finished eating. So I asked the man, sir, where is Joycelyn? He said, oh, I bought an island in Bahamas and I have named it after my wife, who is called Joycelyn. Immediately my prayer changed. I said, God, I will buy an island and name it after my wife, Abigail. Can I prophesy to somebody? Are there millionaires in this house?
Yes.
You will buy an island.
Bye.
You will name it after your pastor. Shout yeah. Yeah.
Sit down.
Me, Joycelyn. So now when the man gets up, he said, I'm going to Joycelyn. So Prophet Daniel will call me, Brian, Chingy, where are you? I said, I'm going to Abigail.
He gave me shelter where there's no one. He makes a way where there's no one. He turned my darkness into light. He put food on my table. He comforted me when I was lost. Who can be compared unto you? How I do Baba, oh, I want to be a little
money you want to see in your life. The highest money you want to see in your life.
$30 billion.
Say it again.
$30 billion.
Go and enjoy it. Take the hands of your wife. Go and stand here. Go. Now, when 10, listen, when 10, when you are coming, walk like a millionaire and the wife. 10, listen. Listen, stop there. 10. Walk like a millionaire and the wife going to a function.
So now, tonight, Yampong, I'm finishing my part. The prophetic pope will come and take over. The Spirit of God told me when I was on the flight. Tonight, you know what? I'm going to call only five people. I'm done. Five people. You'll be thinking that, oh, yes, I've done some things. Tonight, I'm going to challenge people to push them to take over. I was in Texas. Pastor Mark was there in your friend's church. You can call Apostle Esther. I called a man. I said, sir, come. This and this and this and this and that. I'll give you 2 days. By 2 days, a contract of $50 million landed in the man's account. Now the man, the most saddest thing is that the man was looking for me to give me offering. So the man typed Google and typed my name. I don't know whether it's fortunately or unfortunately, Prophet Daniel's name came up. And the man went to Prophet Daniel's website and sent him money. And so when the man called me, so, oh, when I saw it, I thought you are brother, so if I send it to him, you'll get it. I said, ask for money. This man, I won't get it. $50 million! I was shaking. I went to Amsterdam. I was preaching. Media was preaching. God said, Brian, whatever offering they will give you, give it back to the host pastor. I said, God, you are very wicked. The man came, said, man of God, you have done well, this and this. Give me the offering. Though I'm a prophet, when I hold money, though I have not seen the money, I can feel the weight. I know the amount. I held it like this. My hands were shaking. God said, give it back. I said, why do you talk by heart like that? I look at the man. I said, take it, sir. Take back the money. The man was crying. He's a man of God. Since I started ministry 60 years, nobody has done this. I said, don't tell me stories. I'm going. I went to my hotel. I was angry in the spirit. My wife was calling me. My wife calls me B because I'm called Brian. And the B, every day he calls me B. I don't know whether the B is standing for Banku, Banana, Buckley's Bank. I don't know. Then, my wife, as I was angry, I said, God, I have given this money out. I need a surprise. I went to Nigeria. I finished preaching. Big Redeemed Church. A man came to me. He said, prophet, you are very good. I said, thank you. You are talking too much. What is it? He said, when you were preaching, the Spirit of God asked me to do something. I said, sit down. Listen. The man started talking plenty. I said, what is the man saying? He said, prophet, do you have an account? I said, I don't have an account in Nigeria. I said, I have UK account. He said, no, I can do transfer. I said, are you sure? I gave the UK account number to the man. The man picked up the phone, started calling. The man is an Hausa man, started speaking Hausa. Karim. I was scared. I thought this man was from Boko Haram. I said, Jesus. Immediately, the man said, prophet, check your account. I said, hold on. I called my wife. I said, Abby, please, get my ATM card, check my bank balance. My wife went downstairs. The ATM was just right by my house. My wife checked it. Immediately, my wife picked me back. He said, B, you deserve the glory. I said, Abigail, what is it? He said, some money has landed. Guess what?
It was 7 times the money I had given in Holland. The truth is, all right, I know some people are watching, but as of now, we have passed. Be careful. You don't care. No. I got to the airport arrival, and people were looking at my face. They said, "You look familiar." I said, "Yes, I'm the one on the billboard over there." But you know what? This billboard, you can't pay it with anointing. You pay it with money. This man called Prophet Samson has done well. Clap your hands for him. I'm ending on this one. There are some things that you have. It does not belong to you. I'm just calling and challenging 5 people. A plane crash happened in Nigeria. I go to Nigeria a lot. All my friends are Nigerians. A man was on his way to board the flight. He left a document at home. Left it at home. He called the wife, that can you bring it to the airport? The wife said no. The man turned back to pick up the document. Ladies and gentlemen, when the man went back to the airport, the plane had left. After some 3 hours, we saw on the plane, on the TV, that the plane had crashed, Dana Airline. The man was in shock for over 10 days. And the man was praying that, God, why didn't you kill me? Am I that special? And God told the man that, you know what? I could have killed you, but in your family, you pay school fees for over 12 people. If you had died, who would have paid your school fees? Under this anointing, I came from London to challenge people. I know you have given. I was watching it yesterday and last 2 days. I know you have given. There are some monies, if you don't take care, you will die and leave it there. And some foolish family members will fight over your money. Tonight, under this anointing.
Say, South Africa, Brockenhurst. China, Guanizo. Belgium, Brussels. Accra, Ghana. And look for further new branches as to build a generation of spiritual worshipers across the globe. Be sure to join us in our next telecast.